Louis, just in case you get confused, I'm still on the Dutch Mafia's issues, and I've got a long list of those foundations to get through. Just in case you do get confused, I'm going to play you some music to remind you of where we left off on the last issues, and I want to play the same music again, and that could get you confused on the sequencing of my videos. So, Common K is making all sorts of conciliatory gestures. All of the really powerful people in the world, including Commoner Kate and Hannah Rothschild, are now almost full-time engaged in video making and filmmaking. And it makes me feel ever so humble that the very, very beautiful princess has decided to begin to help people with mental health issues. So I'm going to play this music first, just in case you get confused. Okay? So this is one of the memorable films in Hollywood about how people get treated in healthcare in America, where they have to pay for it. Jack Nicholson, the Nicholsons are in the global mafias. They're very prominent in the Dunedin Medical School, let me tell you that. That movie was about taking a fit and competent man and banging him up in the asylum, doping him up with the drugs, giving him the ECT, and then eventually the lobotomy that made him a vegetable. And so Kate is interested in those things since I became interested in her love life and the illegitimacy of that lineage that she now is the boss of, almost, okay? And so she's, as a conciliatory gesture, and I played this very unfriendly music the last time, yeah, because she is absolutely aware of what I'm doing. And she is absolutely intimidated by it. So this is the music that I played before the last one. Today, on this occasion, I'm going to get right on with the videos once I've shown you Connor Kate. Close up, she's lovely, and in every picture now, she's covering up all sorts of issues with the same news releases. So even to the extent that she's released a new PSA surrounding the mental health issues. The PSA is, the Hoik PSA, is one of the youth rugby teams in Hoik where the Victoria frauds occur involving Blind Prince George of Cumbria and Teviotdale. That's Hoik, yeah? The place where the women cannot do the common riding until a few years ago, and the women, the men, are all aware, because they're Freemasons, of the massive joke and the power of Blind Prince George of Cumbria, who sired the only legitimate child of Queen Victoria. Okay, so that's Princess Kate's speech. That's why all the more noteworthy that she's released a new PSA surrounding mental health issues for kids and immature adults that get all insecure about why she's being ballistic about me. Yeah, and it's all to cover it. And every one of the pictures that you'll see has her in the little blue dress for Eva Braun, Bill Clinton, and I can't see any spunk on it because it's only head and shoulders. Okay, here we go. And so, this is the one that should remind you of where we started off the last time.
Am I today?
and that one there is the cover for the We Are the People Rangers video, which is We Are the Ranger Supporters Village People joke about religion arriving in the Protestant form on Staten Island just off New York, yeah, which is the Empire State and will very soon belong entirely to her. Okay, it's really quite amusing how they spend their time, yeah, deploying all of these tools, and there's the little blue dresses, and that's the Rangers colours for all of the kids. Yeah, same for John Lamont, he's dealing now with 8-year-old children on the radio programmes, and he's part of the De Lamonts were in the Dutch mafias that went out only 40 years beyond the Mayflower. Okay, and that's the Van Din mafias that we've been talking about. Let's see how far down the page this goes. So that's the People magazine, We Are the People for Rangers, the Daily Mail, the Daily Star, the People, Explore in Depth, Kate Middleton prepares for new editing job, transforms International Business Times, Prince George loves his new schedule. Yeah, she's gonna be a news person. I might get a job, and that would be lovely, and I might get to meet her mum again. Yeah, right, let's get down to business and where we were on the last one. If you're confused by the title of the last video, which I think was the last video that we made was, I think it's number 4, in the title it says the Why Don't You Like Me, Kate Middleton video, but it also says Dutch RC Mafias. That's because Father McMahon, the parish priest in my own hometown, which I've now returned to, yeah, he's the one that is the McMahons are in the foundations that are the wealthiest people in 1984, chipping in to the global mafia operation. Yeah, and all of it is run in out of those massive Illuminati families, and Kate's doing okay in the interfaces, yeah, between the Windsors and all the others. Yeah, and she might get me in touch in the course of time with Hannah Rothschild. Okay, it's amazing, the whole of it is trivialised all the time. They bring our country to its knees, none of them do anything to try and get things back in place, and I believe strongly that all the mental health attention is because the Freuds are in the Chipping Norton Set, yeah, that's married to Lizzie Murdoch, the daughter of Rupert, the biggest fraudster in the media world. Okay, there's the Hoik PSA. That'll be funny for the Masons in Hoik too. They haven't won the lottery for a couple of weeks now, and it's now this evening beginning to get gusty again, and it looks as if they're in for some weather storms. Okay, whole world is just a Muppet show. Right then, back to the Van Din bloodline, and that's there. And I'll see if I can get it full screen. Oh. Sorry, pressed the wrong button. Let's see if we can get it full screen by... There we go. For a fleeting moment we had it full screen. I'll put that down so I can go with two hands. So we're on those foundations, and every one of them has to be covered up by a news release featuring false news. New launches of pop bands, actors, poets, yeah, and singers like Micah. Why Don't You Like Me, Grace Kelly? Me love to some a little bit shy. Why don't you like me? Why don't you like me? We're about making me try. Thank you.
This is episode 5. Is the Humbolt Scholars in New Zealand in the pharmacy school run by Professor Tucker, who nominated me as a piss take for the Nobel Prize in Chemistry. They got a great sense of humour, the Kiwis have, even the anglicised ones or the Anglican converts, and not very religious land at all, I don't think. Okay, so there's Alexander Humbolt coming up below. And there is, we're off again, okay? These are the foundations that need funding, like the Clinton Foundation, so that the whole of the globalised scams. So there's the Tucker Foundation joke, okay? And there is all their massive websites and their global education stuff, and the only PhD students in the pharmacy school in New Zealand were all but one were Germans, because the Germans are good at manipulating their country, their economy, and everybody else's country, it seems, Kate. Yeah? So that's the Tucker Foundation. Next one up is the Jewett Foundation of California. Now, I wanted to make it full screen, but I'm having difficulty with this wee computer. Let me just see if I can get... No, let's just go. Okay, I want to get through with it because I'm getting bored with this. These are relatively small crimes and the gods tell me I need to move upstairs all the time. So I'll try and show you the shareholdings and the business interests of... Let's do that now. Yeah, we forgot to do that the last time. Okay, so there is Bernardus Cornelis Adriana Marguerite Van Beelden. Yeah? These will be the name.
Meet Peter. He is learning Chinese. He was studying on his own with textbook.
That was not me, by the way. That's Rebecca in Chipping Norton. Okay. Let's just... Okay. So, this is the Dutch Business Registry for Royal Dutch Shell, and it's a cross-gender director. Okay. Bernardus. Yeah, that's the Bernard, was the old Nazi king in Netherlands. Cornelis, Adriana, Marguerite, Van Beelden. With the word bear in it. Do you get it? All through the woods. It's really dangerous, because that's the Rothschilds' bears. Yeah, the predecessors to the Rothschilds opening up. Yeah, and it's the bears of the chemical disasters and all the ecological disasters. Okay, so this is not quite so boring as just listing the foundations that then fund again the super elite families that run all the wars and all the frauds, and there's similarly named officers in the massive Dutch Shell PSC Ponzi schemes and all of the multiple directorates. Yeah, these are the same people, the Rothschilds, with the word bear in their names. Yeah, that run the dinosaur bones scandal, and that runs in the national museums all across the country, and it becomes those massive jokes about finding dinosaur fossils or eggs in crystals and then turning them into massive national parks featuring the dinosaurs. And that is all of Hollywood's output. And it is some of my favourite songs, and all of me watching all of those movies with my kids brings tears to my eyes even today. It's the Negro woman, I forgot her name, that sang If You Hold On Together. Yeah, that's about the dinosaurs and all the dangers of living as a caveman in those early days. Yeah, that's the Genesis story again, okay? So do you see how they scam the money out of the funding streams through the stock market frauds? And in video number, the one I made about the new Dutch Queen, which is this lady, Queen Maxima of the Netherlands, married to Wilhelm, yeah, married to Willem Alexander in the Dutch throne room, yeah, the abdication of Queen Beatrix with the word bear in it. It's ever so funny when you begin to look at it from, yeah, that objective perspective, yeah, and you understand that all of the families that run the world run it entirely for profit, not at all for the people. And that's the Frogmore joke for Mrs. Simpson, buried there after all her sins. And the whole of her life was a party and a sexually deviant orgy, which is why she's so attractive to the royals. And Madonna then makes a movie about her being a heroine, and none of the heroin laundering is mentioned for any of the world leaders in other people's stories. Okay, right, let's get on. So the Jewett Foundation, these are the foundations that soak up the money from the mafias, yet in the childbirth, in the sterilization sector, and all the eugenics that has happened since the eugenicists met in the Hotel Cecil in the 1912 meeting. Yeah, that's the inner circle, the round table for Cecil Rhodes in the Hotel Cecil in London, exactly 100 years before the piss take that was the London Olympics opening ceremony. Yeah, with Ian Fleming the profiteer coming down with HRH, the brother, the sister of Bill Clinton, by artificial insemination of the maid, her mum, who's the race horse, Gigi, yeah, the woman that is the Queen Mum, was a horse racing fanatic, and that is the Governor General Gigi Jokes. The Gigi's are the piezo icon, which is the horse, hippos in Greek, and this Jewett Foundation is registered in Montgomery Street, and that's the Dukes of Buccleuch, and it's registered in Montgomery Street, St. Paul's, Minnesota, where the first and official federal bank is, run by Janet Yellen, who was on the newspapers looking ever so old this week. Okay, so Ross Henderson, Gavin Young. Facebook have the right to post right in the middle of my videos now, and it's run by the CIA, and that is run by the young man who's the entrepreneur, and he made a fortune out of scamming the shareholding releases when they did that. And that foundation that we just saw is about orthopedics. It's about bone structure and all the cripples that you've got and those that lose their legs. That's the orthopedic walk-in, the Jewett Foundation, okay? It's the joints and the myth that the hips don't lie, yeah? It's amazing how many of the folk that are profiteers or jokers in this sector, how many of them get disabled by the gods, yeah? Right, so what's next? So this is boring because these are low-life foundations. Yeah, and they're big in their local regions and they're big in world history, but at the moment the massive central banking scandals are much more important. So here's a Johnson, yeah, that's LBJ's bloodline, that's Jimmy Johnson that got the motor neurone disease in his 40s. Yeah, all my greatest heroes turn out to be the victims of acts of God and have no friends left, except for the new ones that I'm meeting in the supermarket. So Lyndon B. Johnson, Executive Order 1111, Air Force One. That's the movie that was made about the threat from Kurdistan, yeah, of the communists. And all of it is totally invented. It features the woman that has the sex on the kitchen sink with Michael Douglas. Yeah, and round and round we go. She's the deputy president when when Indiana Jones gives his speech in Russia, yeah, and the Russians are on board Air Force One. They steal the weapons because there are several slaves in the American team prepared to take the bun. Yeah, we've told you all about that. The slaves and the household staff are prepared to turn, yeah, and desert everything that they work for so that they can take the bung. And all of that is run by global Freemasons, and every American president has been one. And there's LBJ and Kennedy's wife, yeah, signing away the central bank back to the Rothschilds. That's Executive Order 1111, and that is the two 1111 Freemasonic numbers. Yeah, that steal the whole world from its democracies. Yeah, and those are the people also that are the slaves to the moneylenders, that are the Rothschilds and the massive elite Illuminati families. Although the Kennedys and the Anassises are both independent members of those Illuminati mafia families. And there's his coffin. And the stuff that I told you about the killing the Prime Minister and eating his carcass makes me ever so nervous about Parma ham now, and I love it. And I hate to think what the undertakers around the world, who are maybe evil, yeah, are prepared to do with the carcasses. It does not bear thinking about. But when you read what they do and what they revel in and what they're obligated to do in their nightclubs and sex dens, commoner Kate, it is absolutely astounding that a concept like that is even thinkable. Okay, let's move on. And they demonise, yeah, in the Christian religion, the pagan cannibals that have no income streams. The Christians have already made off with their pearls and their golds, and all of them are in those massive cathedrals that you see if you pay for the Spanish pilgrimage along the Pyrenees. Like our Rhodesian friends whose mum made those trips, and those are the people that become the Earls of Isha. Yeah, and they're in that the round table for Cecil Rhodes. Yeah, the Rhodesian friends that I had in Tring. The Tring, of course, is the Rothschilds' epicentre. Okay, let's get on and see what else we got, because we're only halfway down the Vanden bloodline tab. Oh. Right then, there's Harrison himself, and I've pointed out that Aries and Harry are also jokes about Aries Copernicus Piso. Everywhere you go, you find it. The Isle of Arran, the Arran jerseys for Shania Twain in that lovely song that she sings about being with her lover forever. Yet she's divorced now, and her husband was called Muttley, which is part of the New World Order world ownership cartoons. Yeah, that's Muttley the dog. Yeah, in Hanna-Barbera's output. Okay, and it's Muttley the murderer who was involved with the with George W. Bush and his great-grandfather's oil scams in California. Okay. So there's the culprit. He's in the Fifth Element movie as the baddie as well. And Harrison Ford is the goodie. And that is Radditch. And that is the joke about a vegetable being the leading communist and the man who's going to save the world, because all of them get paid by the Rothschilds. Do you get Radditch? That's a radish, red revolutionary, and he gets shot in the back. As the Fleming parachutes come down like they did in the London Olympics joke. And Queen Elizabeth II will likely die in her bed. She's one of the biggest villains in the world, because they understand what happened to their ancestors, but they will do nothing to change it constructively. Commoner Kate. Right then. Rothschild funded Red Shield for communist menace, illustrated below in a strictly non-violent way. Stalingrad became St. Petersburg, and that is a tragedy. Yeah, that's St. Peter at Bill Gates' pearly gates. Yeah, it's all a massive, massive method for culling the poor people. And 101.5 million people died at what became the head of the Roman Church joke. Never ever lived. St. Andrew is the patron saint of Russia. Never ever lived. St. Andrew's flag is the jocular flag for the Scottish political movement and its independence profiteering campaign. There's the Radditch. Yeah? The Radditch is red, Red Shield for Marx and Engels. Do you get it? Yeah, that's Air Force One about the Rothschilds taking back the American central banks. They now have 26. Yeah? And that was told me by the Buffalo Girl, that is, the Buffaloes are the Bush dynasty, and all of that has been revealed in those family trees. And that is the joke about Jesus, yeah, never living, and St. Peter denying that he ever lived, and the Fox News and the Pathy cock crows three times in triumph, that humans are now stronger than the gods in the heavens. As I keep saying, they have another think coming, and the wind is beginning to gust alarmingly tonight again. This is the joke for the communists. Okay, every one of the great conflicts ends on the Russian front with massive snowfalls. Okay, that's the Stalingrad genocide snowfalls. Yeah, the Russian front is where 1.5 million people died. And there's Putin, who's now in charge of Russia nominally, because all of the G8 leaders are just plants. Yeah, to the moneylenders and the Rothschilds. And none of the Rothschilds, except for Jacob, Hannah's dad, are prepared to come forward and talk. And even he talks about trivia and about the desertion of the EU that they have totally dismembered by design so that they can lead the world in chaos. That's the joke for the Rothschild communist sponsors. Okay, I'll show you a little snippet of that. It is tragic. Absolutely tragic. Yeah, it is Stalingrad, and Stalin is trained in Britain in the lead up to World War II, and FDR, who was trained in one of the American institutions to be its deserter and to take them into the war that he promised to keep them out of. This is what happened in Stalingrad. It is absolutely sick. I'll cite the video, watch it for ourselves. You have not got time to watch all of it. Okay, I think it's the History Channel. And that's the Queen Maxima of the Netherlands, who's taken over from the genocidal people that were involved with Tank Commander Vidal in the killing of all of those innocent people, including priests and teachers.
Stalingrad stands at the top. More than one million lives.
So do you get it? The deadliest and most important battle. Stalin trained in Tavistock, in the UK. Yeah, he got out through the Sydney Street siege with the help of Winston Churchill. Yeah, and all of it is a massive joke, and the Italian fascists are allowed to change sides halfway through. Okay, I will not show you any more. You can look that up for itself. It's 13 minutes long, which is very appropriate because that's the number of the Illuminati family that run the world this way, and they think it's hilarious. That's why Hillary Clinton is called hilarious. Right then, so back to the Dutch bloodlines. It's got very little to do with Dutch people, actually. It's about the migrants that went with the Christian movement, then went with the armies all over the world, yet to keep the numbers of poor people down. Only 1,500 civilians left alive in that town where 1.5 million died. Can you believe that? And there they are, just strewn all over the floor, perfectly preserved. If you wanted to turn them into Parma ham, yeah, that is not a thing that I'm prepared to contemplate. But I was quite shocked when I saw the Rembrandt jokes and the beef hanging and the statements that the Prime Minister was eating. Yeah, I still to catch up with the truth on that and what the names of the people are. Okay, there it is. The Russian front. Absolutely bitter winter. Yeah, and the gods make sure that the humans can no longer stay there and keep killing each other. They're the only people in our universe with a conscience, it seems to me. And I don't know whether or not people is the appropriate word. They are the greater beings that made the universe, and they have now been displaced by the Jesus Christ joke. And that is the elderly Dimbleby, which is the cover for the Thimblebys in the presidential bloodlines, yet that lead to the ancestors of Roosevelt and the Bush family. That that joke for them is that the dad died really young with cancer, and he made a statement in his life saying Jesus wept. And that gave him a conscience, because he knows there never was a Jesus. Okay? And that is where they are fucking trained. And out to the west in Tavistock. And that is where Portendown now makes the weapons of mass destruction and the chemical and biological weaponry that the Freemasons intend to use to destroy the world after they have started World War III. All of it is in Hitler's protocols of Zion, and all of it was what launched World War II out of the lodges there in Frankfurt and in Munich, where Bayern Munich play the football. Do you get it? Incredibly, lethally powerful families. Right, and the swastika was entirely belonged to the whole globe's Freemasons before Hitler despoiled its reputation. Trained in Britain, Hitler Rothschild, born and raised in the Alps, in Innsbruck, like the Popes and the sons of the shoemakers that are the Warner Brothers and Pinocchio. All of it is the joke about Jesus being the boy with no strings to get back to heaven, because he is not actually ever on this earth. And that is soon to be the Easter eggs joke, the Rolling Stones who brutalized all the regions way down here somewhere. Yeah, everything is for profit and is for killing of the ordinary people who cannot read and write. And now all of them are in a panic because they know that I can read and write, and that many, many people are now beginning to listen to me. Despite their absolute torrent of false news and all those cover-ups with the pop bands and the new poets and all the people with their tits out, Commoner Kate. Okay, so what is this one? Stalingrad war dead statistics. just a massive cult. Yeah, everywhere you go. And all the camps that they have post-war, yeah, that's all another death camp opportunity. And you've heard about the eugenics and the opportunities for the entrepreneurial doctors and medics and eugenicists to optimize their methods on behalf of Princess Anne and Prince Philip. Right then, Kalamazoo Foundation, and this is the Charles Bronson jokes, okay? So he gets tits up all the time, yeah? And Titus Bronson is from Kalamazoo, and he runs the foundation, okay? And that is worth a petty amount in 1984, but let me show you the Bronson jokes. It's shooting the pooch, it is crashing into the earth and panicking when you're in the space program, and that is him, the most highly paid actor when the Great Escape movie was made. He's in all sorts of cowboy film roles too. That's him as a coward in the tunnel, because he suffered from claustrophobia. In the tunnel, he lost his nerve, and it led to the fudging of the attempt to release over 350 fully dressed prisoners, and the jokes about the camps being part of the profiteering attempts. The Colditz effort is shameful. They're allowed to take their Batman with them, and that is the joke about the British American Tobacco. And he's got the ciggy hanging out of the corner of his mouth there. It makes you look sexy on screen in the early days of Hollywood. It's the story. Okay, do you get it? So he fudged the campaign. Only 50 escaped, and that is the Piesel code number for the nun in the Christian fake. Yeah, if it had been 300, that would have been Jesus Christ. If it had been 600, it would have been the Christian cross, or the other way around. I keep forgetting which is which. All of it is a huge laugh for all the Masons that run the war on all sides. Yeah, that's Ireland, America, all over Europe. Yeah, right into Poland, where this guy is alleged to have been born, and that's where he escaped to. He was one of the few that got away. Yeah, and he got away with the Australian, and he got away through Spain and the route that Hitler took. Yeah, and he met the French resistance en route, and the whole thing is a piss take, which is why Steve McQueen died at 40, and why the fat Steve McQueen, the Negro man, makes another joke about, I forget what the film was called that you made, but he won the Oscar too. And because these are all the rabbit jokes, the V sign for Winston Churchill, he hopped off the stage with his Oscar when he won it. Yeah, I think that was only 2 years ago. It's all a massive joke. The whole of Hollywood is a joke about the elites being the actors, yeah, and the directors being the actors, and it's all the families that run the world as tyrants and genocidal leaders. Hillary. Hillary. Hell Arius. Do you get it? Right then. And this is the second film that he appears in. So the Minotaur and the US spaceman myths. Okay, they never went to the moon. That's just a studio in Hollywood. And he crashed into the ocean, panicked in the pod when he was learning how to become an astronaut, and they had to send helicopters to scoop him out of the ocean, and they lost the pod and all of their scientific evidence. Okay? So, Polish roots, like the Warner Brothers. They are the propagandists, they are the filmmakers, they are from the Treblinka region, where everyone in their hometown of Krasnoselk was killed so that they could not say that we were neighbours of the American propagandists in World War II. Yeah, that was the Panzer Division, and that's the Pink Panther comedies for Peter Sellers, who's the son of Lord Mountbatten, who was murdered by Prince Philip. J.P. Kaplan Fund, £50,000, their school examination experts, all the little twiddling with the curriculum, getting the Friday afternoon off, all of it is a diversion from all of my news. And none of the kids get the benefit of any of it, because all of them have to pay 60 grand to to get the university education that we used to get for free. Okay, and this is the Keck Foundation. Okay, Keck sounds a bit like diarrhea here, and that is the icon for it. It's the Ku Klux Klan's icon too. And it's about superconductors and all those physical things and the improvement of microscopes that let us see into the atom now, all of the things that God gave us, because they are the masters of the universe. We have to peer into, and we have to make theories that are absolute bullshit, like all of the Big Bang Theory and Stephen Hawking's massive affliction with motor neuron disease. When the God, when they think they're more insightful than the gods give them terrible afflictions. Okay, the Keck Foundation above, and its scientific priorities funded only out of the profits for the mafias. Peter Kiewitt, that's the Kiwi word, is in that. 45,000. Who are all those bricks for? The hole in the Van Dyck. Yeah, that's the Devil's Advocate movie. They keep saying, who are all those bricks for, Kevin? This is Peter Kewer. He was a bricklayer of Dutch descent. Do you get a hole in the wall joke? Right then, keep going. Let's try and get this finished, because I'm bored with this. The gods want me onto the bigger issues. Princess Fergie and all those people. Crania Charitable Trust, 150,000. Wikipedia, Herman C. Cranet. This will be the launch of Herman Munster. After graduating with a degree in mechanical engineers, Sefton the racehorse. Yeah, was hired in 1914, the year the war started, by Sefton Manufacturing Company. Do you see why they need a Sefton racecourse? And I think it got shot down near Mayfair somewhere. A Chicago-based firm that made paper boxes. At age 30, he was transferred to Anderson, Indiana, and became the youngest Sefton employee to be promoted to plant manager. So this is the shipping P&O packaging companies that Michael Moore and George W. Bush made the frauds out of, registered in Dubai. Yeah, and it was a graduate of Brannau College, and it's the Inland Container Corporations. Yeah, Indianapolis. The Inland Container Corporation, with 6 employees, all whom had also quit the company in Anderson. The company expanded and survived the Great Depression during World War II, totally engineered by FDR. Yeah, that's the New Deal, the Lend-Lease scams involving the War Bonds and Bing Crosby and the Masons that killed Princess Grace. Let's move on. Right then. And they are philanthropists now. Yeah, like the Rockefellers and the man from Scotland. Yeah, with the links to the locals called Andersons. Yeah, who was Andre Carnegie, the founder of the Kelso Library. I got fined there last week. They're Sefton the racehorse. Isn't that funny? Yeah, Sefton was a British army horse, killed with 17 others in 1967 in the Prince Albert Hall region, Hyde Park and Regent Park bombings. All of it false news. Look at the fake pictures of the dead horses lying there. No blood. Right then. And that's the same story as the man that works in the HSBC empire, Abu Dawali, who was blown up or beheaded people in the Woolwich region where I got my PhD with Kate Middleton's mum, if it was indeed her. None of them will reply to me with my polite questions. Okay, and there's Mary Decker and all the scams about the Olympics and all the sports diversions. She's being tripped up by an Afrikaner. Yeah, I forget what the name of the other one was, and that is because there's a place called Zolabud, and that is there's a bud is the name of the woman that's in that massive newspaper man's mansion, and that's what my American correspondent wants to tell me about, Yeah, so that is all the rosebud jokes about the biggest newspapers and all, and I believe the rosebud will be the hymen in the vagina. Yeah, it's all really, really sick, and this is a massive catastrophe for America. Yeah, the woman gets tripped by the Afrikaner, and that's the Boer War all over again. Remember the American called Blake. It's Blake's War, and the American activist was the man that riled everybody up as an academic out of America. It's absolutely pathetic, and one of those two, I can't remember whether it's Bud or Decker, they're very close to some of the Indian cull scenes, yeah, out in the, you know, the Midwest. It's just amazing. Right then, Mansanto, and that's not Monsanto, unless it's a spelling error. They gave £5,000. I forget in the last few days what they actually do. Wish to thank the Mansanto. It's in Google Books. It's a foundation, but I didn't think I could suss out what they do. But they're mentioned with the Winslow Foundation. The Winslow boy was on the Mayflower too. Lucille Packard, that's the computer companies. All of the computer designers, they become Hewlett Packard, and they become the company that was in charge of computerizing and registering all of the events and the translation activities at Nuremberg, which lies right between bad Germany and the stories I've told you about Göttingen and there being a no God, for a laugh. Yeah, the Homeland Foundation, the Ortenberg Foundation, Cam Rasmussen Foundation, that's the Denmark connection to the head of NATO. Yeah, NATO's armies was a Rasmussen out of Denmark. Okay, and the Jennifer Altman, that's the Nazis, the Altmans. Let's keep going. Yeah, I'm bored with this. So, only Google Books exporting to, yeah, so it is, there is a Monsanto, but they mean Mansanto, and I cannot see what it actually is. The Winslow Foundation, National Science Foundation, that's another citation for it. Captive Minds, Captive Lives, Essays on Ethics, but no details forthcoming on that one. Oh, here we go. Mansanto. Mansanto International Finance Company. Okay. Musher Foundation. Mansanto Iberia. Okay. So, Financial Services Organization. Manufactured Homes, Volume 3. And did you see at Stalingrad the massive blocks of flats that is the condominium jokes for the pisos? Yeah, that the piso name translates to floors, condominiums, flowers, and various other words, and the whole of flattened Stalingrad ends up as the front face of a condominium, and that's why they call it St. Petersburg later on, because it's part of the Christianity joke too, the killing of 1.5 million people. And all of them are Christians, Russians and the Allied countries. Medical Trust, 600 grand, that's a big one. Making medical spending decisions, the law, ethics, and the man with the ECT machine around his head, and the man with the lobotomy, medical malpractice law and litigation funding. Almost a million, way back in 1984, on the take, how medicine's complicity with big business. Okay, and that's written by a Carsoner, and that's written by a Dunham, and that's written by a Hall, which is married into Rupert Murdoch now. Yeah. So, let's see if we can get down to the... Oh, this is the McGregors, are another foundation, and that's in Hollywood, the Indiana Jones joke about Devlin Macregor and the Fugitive. Can you see it there? Devlin Macregor, coming soon, to a fugitive. Health against wealth, HMOs and the breakdown of medicine, the medical trust unmarked. And that is written by a Spivak, Julius Lewis Spivak, and that is the Spivs and the Spivey that is the prominent investigative journalist. Yeah. And that's a fraud in healthcare in America, where the whole of your healthcare has to be paid for out of your private funds. Okay? Trust in healthcare. So the McGregors are the foundation, and that's Devlin Macregor in the Fugitive film. And the Fugitive film was a soap opera on the telly, yeah, featuring a man in a wheelchair. Yeah, and that was, I can't mind what it was called then, or what the name of the actor was, but that was also the Fugitive movie. It's the same massive joke about the healthcare frauds. Yeah, do you remember it? With Harrison Ford jumping off the massive waterfall, okay? And it's likely some of it is spilled into India, where the poverty is totally astounding. Okay? And that's the Mountbank MD, Member American Medical Trust. India Private Medicine ? And it's the Medical Trust Hospitals, private medicine all over America. Okay? Care, Compassion, Commitment. Metropolitan Life Foundation, another funder, $7,500. Early years. The predecessor of MetLife began in 1863 when a New York City businessman raised $100,000 to fund the National Union Life and Limb Insurance Company. Melodramatic as well. The company insured Civil War sailors and soldiers against disabilities due to wartime wounds, accidents and sickness. Yeah, a severe business depression that began with the panic of 1873 forced the company to contract until it reached its lowest point in the 1870s after observing, and that's the lead up to the depressions before 1914. The insurance industry in Great Britain in 1897, MetLife President Joseph F. Knapp bought industrial or working men's insurance programs to the United States. Okay? Home office of the New England Mutual Life Insurance Company, one of the predecessor companies of MetLife. Okay? All of the insurance scams now, just massive. Yeah? I've got a comprehensive policy, and everything that we got right up to 2000, yeah? Everything was for free, and all your comprehensive policy commitments were honoured. If I broke a fishing rod, I just got a new one from the insurance company. Now you get nothing. You get no interest on your savings accounts, and they're right on the brink of that World War III, engineered by the Masons all across the world from the Protocols of Zion. Next one is the McCoon Foundation. It's got the word coon in it, which that man used all the time. Yeah, that is the actor that played the racist and fascist man in West Arm, in the Cockney accent like Michael Caine in London, and he is the dad of the father of Tony Blair's wife, and he's from Liverpool, and all of them are in the same New World Order deceive, kill and cheat as extremely talented and comedic actors. He was quite offensive to the whole of his audience, but the BBC get away with that, same time as they're launching Marlon Brando to cover the crimes of Brandeis on the Supreme Court in America. Yeah? What was the word that he used? Scouse Git was the Liverpool Git, and the coon is the black man. You might not know that because we're politically correct now. Right then. So, the McCoon Foundation, with the tartan, yeah, like the Scottish rugby uniform, since I started wearing the black watch tartan around my neck for the Melrose School. I've now rejected it because the gods told me to. The McCune Foundation was established in 1979 by the will of Charles McCune, the donor of a director of the Union National Bank of Pittsburgh for 56 years. Served as president from 1945 until 1972. I wonder where he came from. Like Marlene Dietrich. Okay, the tartan, yeah, is telling. Yeah. Yeah, like the Carnegies and the Andersons and the Lynx. And they got injured on the rugby pitch, the Carnegies did. They had to come off. Two of them in the same match or the same weekend. Yeah, and they're my best mates, and they've served in the army, and they were very compelling, and they looked very genuine when they came back from their service in Iraq. It's just amazing, and the gods give them the injuries right on cue. Okay, Western Pennsylvania counties. Oh, this is the carve up of the counties, and look at the names of the county regions: Allegheny, Armstrong, Beaver, Bedford, Blair, Butler, Gambina, Cameron, Clarion, Clearfield, Crawford, Elk, Erie, Fayette, Forest, Green, Indiana, Jefferson, Lawrence, McKean, Mercer, Somerset, Venango, Warren, the rabbit's joke, De La Warren, yet the naming of Delaware, crossing the Delaware for America's democracy, Washington, Washington was Rothschild. They're all Freemasons, and Westmoreland. More information on grant-making guidelines. So you get your money from the Masons that are the Mafias, that are the Presidents, that are in the Lodge and generate every great conflict. In Homeland Security, tightly wrapped up in their bed when they die in America, which has never been a field of conflict because they're ever so cowardly and deceitful. Right. McCune is the son of Janet Lockhart. Yeah, that's Craig Lockhart. Yeah, where the launch of the partitioning of Pakistan and India took place. McCune and John Robinson McCune, tracks ever so carefully covered, but they have links to Blair and possibly Alf Garnett. And there's the genealogy for McCune. Okay, that's Blair. The liar, Blair, yeah, Linton Blair on the business register, and in the toilet incident with the homosexual, yeah, the business registration frauds and the genocide in Iraq is much more serious. Devlin Macregor, the Macregor Foundation, $5,000 in 1984. This is the fugitive joke. Okay, and if you look for that now, you get an ad for the Macregor Foundation, and it tells you that Devlin Macregor, if you look up Devlin Macregor on the internet, on YouTube, you find a statement saying that the doctor, that is Harrison Ford, actually killed his wife, and he's been rearrested, and he's going to get prosecuted, and the pharmaceutical company is innocent. The Macregor Foundation Board of Directors favours grant request that meet the needs of the economically disadvantaged and the elderly in the following priority areas: home and community. Oh, it's the care homes launch. Okay. The care home launched, one assumes, with a strictly amateur ethic. It's £800 to £600 a month to pay for granny in the care home, and everybody that owns their own home has to give it back to the money lenders that gave them the right to own their own home. And that is Nigella Lawson's dad. It's Nigel Lamont. It's John Lamont's predecessors. And that is Norman Lamont. Massive real estate frauds. Yet the selling of the home from the council, and all of the councils now have privatised the care homes on their own behalf. Alistair Hatton. Miss Tom, it's tragic. Okay, the Macregor Foundation grant recipients, 2004-14 grant recipients. I could show you it, but I want to get down because I'm getting bored with this. Okay, here's the Constitution Committee. a Mike Meyer on it, yeah, that's The Spy Who Shagged Me, a Hilton, that's The Presidential Bloodlines, an Alfano, a Fabino, Marcia Egbert, that's the Bertie, yeah, just to let them know it's us, David P, I can't see what that one is, Hanky, and that's the one who's in charge of the SOE, or one of the intel organisations in the lead up to World War II. Kyle Hodges. Hodges is a massive fraudster in the HSBC. He is in the cast of the Dad's Army jokes. Sharon Milligan. Spike. Spike from the Ecclesiastes, the Eccles jokes. Yeah, about Ecclesiastes. A Murphy and a Nagel. It's a very strange name for the Borders, but Jedburgh Rugby Club has it. Nyshwander and Warren the Rabbit, the Dilla Warren jokes. Yeah, all of it. The Warren Commission is the inquest into the killing of John F. Kennedy. Isn't that funny? Killed by Permindex, which is Beaverbrook and Churchill. Assassination bureaus and all the mind control people are the people that take the blame for it and get shot down much later in the presence of all of America's false press. And the McGregor Foundation is actually something else entirely. It's about care homes, okay? Yeah, with the Tudor design for a laugh. Okay, Rob Roy McGregor, this is the rape, and that's the Archie character. That is the joke about Bonnie Dundee and all of the jokes. And this one is the man who plays Schindler, and what he does when this one's fighting him to the death, and he's an expert with the sword and everybody knows that, and all the Dukes of Argyll are betting on him. Yeah, and that's the Dukes of Argyll that are the traitors in the Dundee region. And Lord Guthrie, who's the boss at NATO's armies when we brutalise the Balkans, yeah, he is on the board of the NM Rothschild Bank, and all of it is a piss take out of Hollywood. And when his wife dies on the ski slopes, it becomes a tragedy because she's in the fucking Time Team Joker and she's Queenie, yeah, and her suitor, yeah, that is Flash, dies really young also. The gods are really, really dangerous if you rile them up by portraying the national treason that has led to the absolute dismemberment of everybody's countries. I forget what his surname was. It's one of the famous clan names too. Look up the cast of Rob Roy McGregor. He's the one that rapes the Scotswoman, yeah, on the kitchen table. And Schindler does for him because he grabs his sword, and eventually that is what turns the tables. Okay? One to one, single handed combat. There's no pictures of the rape of the wife. And that's England in Scotland manipulating our future. Here's the Devlin McGregor t-shirt. There's the culprit that profits from falsifying the evidence on the cancers and the progression of the liver cancers. And I was an expert in all of that cytology, and I used to be referees on all the trivia. And there's the one-limbed man that was actually the murderer of Fugitive's wife. And there's the fugitive with the word Arius in his name, Harrison Ford. Every one of the roles that he's playing, I'm actually engaged in genuine frauds and I'm confronting them. And he crashed his plane earlier last year. Okay? What's this one? Devlin McGregor. This is what you find now on the internet. You find a whole series of wedding photos. Yeah, and you can find, if you keep looking hard enough, you'll find... Okay, we've lost that. You find the ad telling you that the fugitive is really the murderer and that Devlin McGregor are innocent. Yeah? And this one's got a body double in the supermarket too, okay? And all of that's what happens to everything now. Beckham is also translates as God. David Beckham in today's girly magazines is now being divorced from Victoria, because I revealed that 2 days ago, or maybe 3 days ago, because they've blocked most of the recent videos as I processed them overnight. Okay, this is the muskie joke that led us to finding the deputy dog jokes about the echo, yeah, and all of law enforcement just echoing back what the media report as false news stories. And all the prosecutions of the judiciary and all the write-ups of every scam like that in the falsified papers is typical of what we have today. That's why David Bowie was quite happy to pass on, because he knew in the singing of that song, Where Are We Now, that the whole of the history of his life and that period was a total disaster for the world. He understands the weather storms and the snow and the rain and Where Are We Now and the need to walk the dog as the war did. Yeah, and that's God on the end of the lead for the jokers. And look at the jokers. Wedding photos. Yeah. And the muskeg. Muskeg is mud that sucks you under, and Andrew Rice told me that. He's a Norwegian elite. Yeah, he's a professor at Imperial College London in intensive care, where they threw me out of the journal sectors. Yeah, and he nominated me to be speakers at international meetings when I was working in the South Pacific. And he had his heart attack just after I came home. He used to take me fishing on the test and the itching. And there he introduced me to the chairman of the Wild Trout Society, who was feeding trout with pellets when I first met him. He now lives right opposite the Duchess of Sutherland, in a tiny little village where a Christian church has a neck brace for the women who get out of wedlock, to the people that live in the Duchess of Sutherland's home and the Dukes of Sutherland. It's all quite tragic, and all of that becomes Muskie, the cartoon character, and the moles that are blind, and they build the mole hills that become the Piso Mountains, and they paint the fence and they stand behind the fence. That's the whiteboard joke. And this is the story about law enforcement and deputy dog just saying what he's told to say, and that becomes the echo joke and the ownership of vast tracts of land like Yosemite, and that's Yogi Bear. And that's Yogi Hughes on the wing for Celtic. All of them fraudsters, and all of them the elites that are involved in the negotiations and all the treason in the Braveheart film. Ned Moore Fund, Edward John Noble, Norton Company, have you heard of them? Yeah, 25 grand's worth of investment from the mafia, and what you get for that is a massive cover-up. You get the launch of computer security, and this is a British story. Lord Norton in Birmingham, the slaving centre, yeah, where the woman that wants me sectioned that works in Sainsbury's with the Birmingham accent, she looks like a goddess, she's very like one of those opera singers that sing in the Mozart operas about not having access to your family. Yeah, she wants me sectioned, she's from the intel sector, and they all are swarming around my town, and they're all now really excited. Several times in recent months she'd had bits of her body in plaster and bandages, because the accidents that happen are not accidents. Lord Norton in Birmingham formed an association to develop and manage an approved school in the city for boys who had offended against the laws of the day. That's a Borstal, Auntie Mary. You remember the little notice you had above your kitchen sink? I hope that your kitchen sink was not used like Michael Douglas did it, use it, and that the woman who played the deputy president when Radditch was the communist. Yeah, it's just shocking. Yeah, everything's a joke for them. So named after Lord Norton. So he is a Borstal boy himself. Yeah, isn't that funny? Bad behaviours, and that's the red and white stripes that they have as they slit the throats and shag the wives on the prima nocte jokes in the Braveheart movie. Yeah, and when he says to the woman that gets her throat cut, this is the way that you treat your landlords. Yeah, by refusing to be raped by three of our army people at the same time. Yeah, all of it typifies what England and Scotland's interrelations represent. Okay, so he was gifted the lordship, yeah, because he's a Borstal boy and he's a good lad. That's the whole of the peerage gets that now. No one is good. If you're good, you get the NHS treatments that Commoner Kate is now giving to the children. Okay? She's just doing her best to earn what she's already stolen. Okay? Norton Foundation projects. Information for applicants. Registered charity number. Yeah? Richard Perkins. Change of address. The new address is the Norton Foundation. 50 Brookfield Close. Brook, the name Brook, do you remember that from the Pope's stories yesterday? Hunt End, Redditch, Huntsville. Yeah, the fascists in the red coats, yeah, become the fascists in the black coats. In the Fox News, Basil Brush, Basil Fawlty, everything's an interlocking joke, and the Brookfield joke, and the no room at the Innsbruck is a massive belly laugh for all of them. I'm going to lose my voice and I don't think I'm going to finish. Yeah, so the Norton Foundation holds funds to support young people who are under the age of 25, live within the area of the boundaries of Birmingham, Solihull, Coventry, and that's the Coven witchcraft place, and the county of Warwickshire, where Tom of Warwick comes from, and he believes that King Arthur's a really good guy and he's really unlucky not to deliver civilization in that massive fraudulent story that was written by the popes in Rome, and their fraud is even bigger. In need through some aspect of disadvantage, as in care or in need of rehabilitation, lapsing into delinquency, suffering from maltreatment or neglect, or whose potential is not yet realized due to circumstances beyond their control. Okay? The NortonFoundation.org. These are the covers. Ken broke his hand like me. Could be a good man. Okay? Muhammad Ali, the Liverpool jokes. That's Lord Liverpool, Lord McCartney, and Muhammad Ali is the insider trader in India. Isn't it funny? And I lobby him and his organisation, and all it does now is to merchandise. The man has Parkinsonism, and he may well have been given a drug to give him that. I know the drugs that they use for that in the laboratories. Okay, there's the Norton Internet Security. So do you get it? The Borstal boy gets the lordship, yeah, and becomes the head of the foundation. It's like that story I told you about the kidnappings in America. They get all of the money paid and it's just scammed out of the insurance industry. And there's what I'm telling you, okay? The woman misbehaves in rejecting the rape attempt by the three people all over her. Yeah, and she has to keep her marriage to Braveheart a secret. And he accuses her of bad behaviour. The Packard Foundation, okay? David and Lucy Packard. Yeah, Lucifer Packard. That's another computer company. They're the richest people in the world now. That's what Bill Gates does. That's what the other computer companies does. Steve Jobs. And that's the joke about Job in the Bible and him being God's closest friend, which is why he died really young. 2011. Okay? Showing the results of Hewlett-Packard, and they are the ones that developed the computers to translate everybody's speeches, defence and accuse messages from the attorneys at Nuremberg. And Nuremberg is halfway between the birthplace of Pope Ratzinger and the bad region of Germany that is the no-bombing region of Göttingen, which is no God. It's going to be a stormy couple of days ahead, one would predict. Yeah, I'm fallible. Yeah, the gods are perfect. And they're wide awake now, and everybody's becoming aware of it. There's the Turkish moon for the Dutch mafia's half moon. Right, let's go. Two thirds of the way down, I might get on to some topical stuff. Oh, here's Frank Pantangeli, and this is Nuremberg, because Martin Bormann was tried at Nuremberg, but he was not actually tried there. He was in the witness chairs. His body double was tried and convicted, okay? And the joke about that in Hollywood is Frank Pantangeli, that's the five New York mafia leaders that become the New York Angels and become the five news agency for Fox News. Pantangeli turns Queen's evidence, refuses to denounce the godfather that is his boss because his brother comes into the witness stand and he is the mafia member from Sicily, and then he is committed to committing suicide and dying in his bath and bleeding himself to death. Yeah, it's the same joke as Martin Bormann's trial. He was in the witness stand and his body double was executed. Isn't that funny? And that's the mind control that can happen to people like Mrs. Valerie Jane Lees and even the people that are in the clergy. It's quite shocking. Anna Kate's body double was in the Jedburgh shop that was it's a Jewish name. They're one of the Jewish aristocratic families. They're also in the carve-up of the land. And I forgot the name the other day. But it is... I've worked for them on the river. And I've tried to get work with them on the shoots. And her name... She's had a fallout with her brother. And the territory they have on either side of the River Tweed has been carved up between them. And she is, I can't remember it. Lovett, yeah. So they are Jews, and they're one of the few Jewish families in this region. Okay, and she's quite poorly now. Okay, Hewlett-Packard PC wardrobe sizes used by Professor Trevor Jones. Yeah, that's the computers I had in my labs were the size of a wardrobe. Yeah, and that's the era after which we had gone to the moon. I was just a boy when we went to the moon. It's a massive joke. Yeah, like Frank Pantangeli and the Nuremberg trials. All of the innocents get topped and all of the tyrants and fascists get shipped out through the Canaries to a life in pleasure, to die in their beds in fascist places like Argentina, and then they come out of there to become the Queen of the Netherlands. And all of them confess to all of those crimes and nobody gives a monkey. Okay, to launch, this is Trevor Jones was my boss when my computer was the size of a wardrobe, and that's Trevor Jones that is now on the Forbes rich list. And he never appears at the Jehovah's now since I reported their frauds. Yeah, it's just massive. And the toll, I don't know how they live with themselves. Yeah. Under Jehovah's guidance, previously took man to the moon. Okay? Computers were massive then. Now they're inside your mobile phone for everybody. And Rebecca listens to your every word in Chipping Norton. On behalf